going over by assessing general survey and vitals. So I'm gonna look at her and assess her level of consciousness, her health and hygiene, her overall mental status, and signs of distress. Then I'm going to check in her vitals. So first, I'm gonna start with the blood pressure. Yeah, 126 on the 78. All right, now I'm gonna check your pulse and respiration. Six to eight beats per minute. And I'm gonna observe your respiration. I'll also assess her temperature and her oxygen saturation. What's your height?
5'6".
And what's your weight?
120.
And I'll use her height and weight to calculate BMI. Right. Now I'll move on to the examine her head. So I'm looking for any signs of distress or deformities, and I'm also palpate for any tender parts of my head.
Okay, now we're going to move on to.
So I'm gonna palpate your parietal glands.
So right now I am inspecting
your frontal sinuses and your maxillary sinuses. While I'm here, I'm examining the hair for texture, distribution, and quantity. And I'm also assess the temporal mandibular joint while I'm here. So I'm going to palpate.
Okay. Now we're going to chest.
Open the bottom. All right, good. Try to move the jaw from side to side. Stick it out for me and bring it back. Okay, good. Pretend like you're chewing on something. So I'm gonna assess the temporalis.
Okay. Now we're gonna check for
muscle and as well as the temporal arteries.
Constriction.
And the mastitis. Right. So now we'll go into the eye exam.
Okay, now we're gonna check for the corneal.
So I'm observe the eyes on the outside of the eyes.
Now we're gonna check for the
rest. Now we'll look on the inside of the inner eyelids. Look at the square of the pupil.
Now we're going to test eye
contact. And iris. Now I'm gonna start the pupil exam and measure the size of the pupil. So it's 5, I'm do directly in consensual light. Good. Now, do extra ocular movement. Alright. Follow the pen for me. Turn the light back on. Look straight ahead for me. Alright. So now I want you to look at my finger. Then look off in the distance at the wall behind us. Alright, good. Now look back at my finger. Alright.
Now we're going to move on to the
stop painting.
So normally the light
in the room. So now we'll go ahead and do visual acuity. So I want to have you cover your right eye. You got a contact in? Okay, so vision will be uncorrected. Cover your right eye. Hold this up. Hold it up. Alright, read the lowest line possible.
5, 6, 3, 2, 9, 7.
Alright, switch eyes for me. Read the lowest line possible.
5, 6, 3, 2, 9, 7.
Alright. 20, 30. Alright, so I want you to test your visual field now, so I want you to cover your right eye. Alright, so tell me what number I want to know. Alright, good. So now we'll go into the fundoscopic. I would usually turn the lights off, dim the lights. Alright, so now we're going to move on to the nose. So I'm going to assess the nose for any signs of damage or whatever the word is. See if it's like uneven or anything. Alright, good. So now I want you to close one nostril. Breathe in and out. Alright, switch sides. Breathe in and out. Good. Now we'll go ahead and go ahead and look inside the nose at the septum and turbinates.
Good.
the lips, the gums, the teeth, the salivary ducts, and the uvula. Raise your tongue up. All right, good. Stick your tongue all the way out. Say ah.
Ah.
All right, good. Now we'll move on to the ear exam portion. So examine the ears and do a full test and check for any tenderness. And examine the ear canal, looking at the canal, tympanic membrane. Now we'll go ahead and do a whisper test. So I'm gonna say an order of numbers and let us get out to you repeat.
4, 5, 6. Okay.
6, 2, 3. All right, good. So now we'll move on to the neck exam.
And we're gonna start
I'll start off assessing the neck for any deformities or any abnormalities. Then I'm gonna assess the vasculature, the muscles, and the thyroid.
And now we're gonna check chest expansion.
All right. Can you swallow for me?
Good.
And I'm gonna palpate the lymph nodes of the neck. So submental. So mandibular. Tonsillar. Preauricular. Postauricular. Occipital. Anterior. Cervical. Posterior cervical. And the deep cervical. And clavicular. So now we'll go into the thorax and lungs. So, so first I'm gonna observe for any sound of stress breathing, the chest contour and shape of the chest and back, and any sound of color changes. Can you turn them in?
Right.
So the first thing, we're going to palpate for 10 minutes. I want you to breathe in and out for me. One more time. Good. Now we're going to tactile framing. So when you feel my hand, I want you to say blue balloon.
Blue balloon.
About 2.5 centimeters.
All right, good. Now we'll go ahead and process. When you feel my stethoscope, I want you to breathe in and out with your mouth open. Around for me. And we're gonna do the exact same thing. Right. So I'm gonna start off. It says continue. So, breathing out. Go ahead and go into the abdominal exam. So, oh no, cardiovascular first.
And now we're going to auscultate for the
to do the medication for any signs of distress, breathing, or color changes. So first we're gonna check her jugular venous pressure system. Listen to the carotid arteries. Now we'll go ahead and go into the precordial exam. So I'm starting off palpating for EMs and thrips. So check the five places in right here. There we go. There we go. All right, good. Now we're going to go come from the bottom. Hold that one.
Now we're going
to
do the spine. So, you can stand up.
All right, good. I'm going to do the same thing with my hand. Turn on your left side. Good. Now I'm gonna palpate her point of maximal impulse. Okay, now we're going to do this. So now we'll go into the abdominal exam. Do you have any pain anywhere in your abdomen? Good, and I'm gonna observe the abdomen for any protrusions or abnormalities. Alright, so I'm gonna start off by auscultating the arteries. Auscultate each quadrant.
Okay, while you're standing, we'll go ahead and check the knee flexion, the common flexion, extension, flex the other knee,
Okay, you can have a seat and then we'll see your knee inspection. So we're going to be medial lateral. Then we're going to percuss each quadrant. So now while I'm here, we'll percuss the liver. All right, so we'll raise the bottom as well, just a little bit. Right at 6. Alright, good. So now I'm gonna palpate. So I'm gonna palpate lightly in each quadrant.
No, I mean, I feel like you have two really good options.
No, it is about. Now I'm gonna palpate deeply, so you may feel a little discomfort. Measure her aorta. Now I'm going to palpate the edge of her liver, so I want to push all your air out from you. So we'll kind of do skin and peripheral vascular together. So I'm gonna look at the arms, and I'm gonna look for any changes in temperature, texture, color, anything like that. Feel. Alright. So I'm here, I'm gonna start checking pulses. So I'm gonna check regular pulse. Alright, good. I'm gonna check one. Check for dimpling or clubbing or any sign of that. All right, good. All right. Check it. Same thing in the legs. We'll assess the skin for any changes. Temperature, texture, color changes. All right. So I'm gonna assess the positive pulses. So same thing, assess the feet, the bottom of the feet, bottom of the toes actually kind of blue. Check pulses first, posterior tube. Make sure I check between each toe. And her capillary refill and her toes are unable to be assessed as well. Alright, let's go MSK. So we go active range of motion. We already did the temporal mandibular joint. So I want you to bring your arms all the way up. Right back down. Bring them all the way out. All right, good. So tilt your head to the east side. Make it touch your shoulder. All the way back. Look down. Good. And look left and right. All right, good. Bring your elbows all the way up. Bring them all the way out. Good. Pronate. Sweep the neck. Turn them on. All right. Make a fist. Walk your hands all the way back up. Bring your wrist all the way up. All the way down, bring your thumbs to your fingers. Good. Sit. All right, stand up for me. All right, so will assess the spine, starting with the cervical spine. Good. All right, touch your toes for me. Oh, my bad. I'm sorry. Hold it. So we can touch the spine. Stand back up. All right. So hands on your hips. Lean all the way back for me. All right. Lean to the left. Lean to your right. All right. Good. You can sit back down. All right. So now I'm gonna go through and palpate everything. Oh, make sure you look and check for any abnormalities and signs of swelling or erythema. Go ahead and do your recent hand. Good. And I will also check the passive ranges of motion. All right, so let me have you stand back up again. So let's go through active ranges of motion. So pull your the gown up just a little bit. So I want you to bring your knee to your chest, both sides. All right, bring one leg out. Bring it all the way back in across your body. So now rotate it in and out. There you go. In and out. Good. All right. Bend knee. All right. Stick it all the way out. Bend it back. Good. Same thing on the other leg. All right. Good. Turn around real quick. So we assess the SI joints. Posterior. All right. Bring your right leg up, right knee to chest. All right, good. Switch. Probably the pitch. All right, leg press, turn around. All right, same thing. Bring the other leg up. Good. And bring the leg all the way back. Good. All right, you sit back down. So I'm gonna go through and palpate. All right, bring your feet all the way up for me. Push them all the way down. Bring your toes up. Toes all the way up. Curl them for me. All right, good. Also assess each joint before passive range of motion in all directions. Also.